Dear Razer, could you come up with a simpler naming scheme? I mean, it's not easy to pronounce. Is it called Razer Basilisk? I'm not sure. But anyway, let's jump into the simple specification of this mouse right here. It uses Razer's 5G optical sensor with 16,000 DPI, a DPI number they are unlikely to use in everyday situation. It has this 50G or gravity acceleration, which translates to 450 inches per second. It uses Razer mechanical switches, yada yada. But the thing here is, it's a first-person shooter mouse. Now, in the past, almost a year and a half plus ago, I used to promote and recommend one mouse and only one mouse, which was the Logitech G502 Proteus Spectrum or Proteus Core. That is the first-person shooter mouse to go. A year and a half later, almost 2 years, this is the mouse that I'm going to recommend today that beats that mouse, and this is my three reasons why I would recommend this mouse as a first-person shooter mouse for you. Now let's talk about the first one, which is right here, the DPI clutch button right here. Holding it, it's really comfortable. Now, the way this DPI clutch button works, or aka the sniper button works, is great for sniping characters or scoping shots. For example, for me, when I play Overwatch, I play two main characters, which is Ana or Widowmaker. And my mouse overall DPI setting is 600 sensitivity with in-game 10 sensitivity. By holding this DPI clutch button, it temporarily changes the DPI settings to my preferred choice, which is 400 DPI with the in-game settings of 10, helping me to track and do follow up headshots and body shots for the team kills or healing for Ana. Releasing the DPI clutch button, it returns to the normal 600 DPI with 10 sensitivity in game. Now, by having the DPI clutch button, I don't need to make my thumb change to an awkward 90 degree, which is very uncomfortable for long sessions of gaming. Now I have three controls: DPI clutch, melee and reload. This is a game changer. Plus, it's easy to swap it. If you don't like the long one, you can change it with the short one or disable completely. It's magnetic, so you can swap it. The second reason is you can control the sensitivity of the scroll wheel right here. Now, the Logitech G502 only had two options: hyper-scrolling, which is great for social media, web browsing, and basically Excel spreadsheet. It's terrible in-game. And the other option is just the step-by-step, which does not give you much flexibility. Whereas the Razer Basilisk, that's how to pronounce it, gives you the option to change the resistance of the wheel mechanically, which is this slider right here on the bottom of the mouse. So you can have it like, for example, very low resistance, easy and smooth scrolling, and on the fly you can make it to be higher resistance, and it's small incremental steps right there. Now it's really hard to actuate it, so I can change it to make it a little bit more easy to actuate it, and it's great for games like, now I'm playing a lot, Fornite. Now in Fornite, you have the option to use a scroll wheel to change your build option, maybe a wall, sliding, or basically pyramid, or playing traps. Aside from that, you can use it to swap your weapons, like a shotgun to a minigun quickly. This scroll wheel resistance option right here is a good option for Fortnite player who wants to switch their weapons or build option quickly. Next is ergonomics. Now my hands is 18cm long by 10cm width. The mouse on the other hand is 12cm long with a 7.4cm width. So basically when I use a fingertip or claw type, it does not touch the surface, especially this part right here. And I can glide very smoothly. It feels very comfortable despite having a low profile and right here, the height right here. Now, if you're a palm user, definitely there's roughly 2cm of skin that is touching the surface, but that it does not introduce much drag, number one, because the thumb area is sitting on this latch right here, so you're not touching the mouse pad. Number two, there is three glide pads right here that when you're using a plastic surface, it glides butter smooth. There are other features including the macro keying, hyper shift to double up your keys, there's the X and Y sensitivity control, there is basically the RGB chroma lighting setup that you can play around with. But in summary, I would say that this mouse fits to two categories. Number one, if you are a quick scope person like me, Widowmaker, Ana in Overwatch, DPI Clutch is a plus point. Now, if you're a person that plays a lot of Fortnite with a scroll wheel type of user that like to switch a weapon or build option quickly rather than keyboard macros, this is another plus point. And a lot of players right now, I see they are going with two categories of game, PUBG or Fortnite. And oftentimes I see people are getting a very heavy mouse. And I would always recommend getting a first person shooter mouse with the lightest possible weight. And this is one of them that fits the category. It's comfortable ergonomic wise, the glide is smooth, and it's lightweight. So thanks for watching this video. Comment below what other Razer products that we can review next, because I'm going to visit their office and return this mouse. Sadly, it's not mine. I wish it's mine. I want to keep it, but I can't keep it. So let me know in the comments. So see you guys in the next Razer review, which is going to be a speaker if I'm not wrong. Peanut butter jelly or peanut butter ice cream? Which one would be preferred?